It's the NBA on ESPN. I'm Stuart Scott bringing you the lowdown. Stephon Marbury's game just exploded the moment he entered the NBA, and kid has not looked back since. It's hard to believe that Steph is already entering his ninth season, but he's only 27 years old, and that means he is still in the prime time of his playing years. Bulls, Knicks, it's on.
Welcome to today's exhibition matchup here at the world's most famous arena, Madison Square Garden in New York City. The New York Knicks will square off against the visiting Bulls here on the NBA on ESPN. Evening, everyone, along with Bill Walton, Bob Fitzgerald on hand. Michelle Tafoya will join us in a bit. As we watch the teams warm up, Bill, which players do you have your eyes on?
Fitz, you have to be pretty good just to get on the floor in this league, but these guys are really something special. Allen Houston is an extraordinarily talented shooting guard. One of the things that makes him so efficient is his excellent free throw shooting. Give him two free throws, he'll give you 2 points. It's as simple as that. Standing just across the court is another difference maker. Kirk Heinrich is one of the better point guards in the entire league. He has that knack for making the right decision offensively. When he's on, he can manipulate defenders like puppets.
Thanks, Bill, and without further ado, it looks like they're getting set up for the tip-off. The Bulls get the tip, and we're underway. Michelle Tafoya has some extra info for us. Michelle?
Thanks, Bob. I spoke with the Knicks head coach before warm-ups and asked him about his game plan. He said, quote, "We're hoping to let our offense loose and just make plays. If there's a team that can do it, it's these guys." Fitz, back to you.
Thanks, Michelle. The layup is off target by Heinrich. Thomas. Thomas rips it down inside. Hits the left rim and out.
That one was his to make, but I guess with the defenders nearby, he just got flustered. Better luck next time.
Pass to Chandler. To Heinrich. Looks to break his man down. 7 on the shot clock. Let's fly from the wing. It's good.
Watching this one again, I'm even more impressed, Fitz. You have to capitalize on every scoring opportunity, just like he does here.
The Knicks working up court, and they're behind 2-0. Skips it to Muhammad. Hands it to Houston. From deep three-point range, Curry goes way up to get that rebound.
Bob, this is ridiculous. He threw that thing up from another area code. I know he's a great three-point shooter, but that is ridiculous.
Pass to Davis. Unloads from 9. Reeled in by Muhammad. They bring it up court. About 3.5 minutes left here in the first. Passes to Houston. Feeds it down low. Raises up. Drops.
I like the play in real time, Fitz, but I like it even better in replay. I love seeing all the hard work that goes into getting a bucket.
The pass to Chandler. The skip pass to Heinrich. 7 on the shot clock. Stops and pops. No luck.
Kirk Heinrich won't get easy looks like that every time down the floor. He's got to make the most of those.
Skip pass to Thomas. Thomas. Davis pulls it down inside. To Chandler. The pass to Gordon. Passes to the baseline. To the bucket. Finishes with a soft touch.
Impressive play, Fitz. This one's worthy of a second look.
Muhammad inbounds to Marbury.
I got it.
They bring it up court. 2:10 left in the first quarter.
Tighten up. Play them tight.
Pass to Houston. Passes to Houston. Gives the up fake. The tray. Buries it.
Allen Houston has great awareness on the offensive end. You got to make it a top priority to keep close to him.
The Bulls work it up court, and they're down by one. Pump fakes from 20 feet out. Grips court. The bounce pass to Thomas. Bounce pass to Thomas. The dish to Houston. Shoots right block. Gets the bucket.
When you get in close like that, you have to be able to seal the deal no matter how much traffic you're in, Fitz. That was a nice play.
They bring it up court. 1:23 left in the first. The pass to Chandler. Bounces it to Heinrich. Sizing up his man. Releases. Flips it in for two.
He doesn't have the best crossover in the game, but he decided to drive with it that time, and you know, it worked out for him perfectly. Nice play.
The Knicks advance it. We have a one-point game. To Thomas. The pass to Muhammad. Passes to the left corner. Shoots with the clock winding down. What a pass by the tenured vet out of TCU. Inbound pass to Heinrich. Skips it to Davis. Swings it to Chandler. 7 on the shot clock. Takes the turnaround, Jay. Nails it.
It's always a good thing to see players making plays. He saw the opening, and he took it in to score the basket.
They bring it up court. 19 seconds left in the first. The skip pass to Thomas. Passes to Muhammad. Backs in. Pass to Houston. Lets it go from the wing. Yes. Cannons it the entire length of the court. Offline. We're at the end of one and it's close. The score, 11-10. Thomas, inbounds to start the second quarter. Gives the up fake. Marbury, 3 rebounds now by Muhammad. Gets the bucket. The pass to Gordon. Pass to Heinrich. Cuts to the rack. He has the shot. Skip pass to Thomas. The bounce pass to Muhammad. To Thomas. From 11 feet away. Hits right rim and doesn't fall. Passes to Chandler. The pass to Davis. Tries to post him up. With the hook shot. Thomas hauls it in off the defensive glass.
When you take that kind of shot, you failed on offense. No ifs, ands, or buts about it.
Passes cross court. Dumps it inside. Shoots from the post. Snatched down inside by Curry. pass to Gordon. The pass to Curry. Passes to Heinrich. 5 on the shot clock. Shoots from the corner. Thomas scoops up his 4th rebound so far.
The defender had him hearing footsteps, and he couldn't maintain concentration on the shot. Nice D there.
Off the right rim, but missed by Marbury. Went with the lay-in, but it's missed by Marbury. Pass to Gordon. Is looking to do something with it. Fires from the high post, drops.
This one looks even better the second time, Fitz. Nice play to get to the bucket.
The Knicks bring it up court. They're shooting 40% from the floor. Pass to Houston. To stop the drought. Chandler crashes the boards.
That's exactly the kind of shot you want, Fitz. You can't ask for better execution on the offensive end, but sometimes those shots just don't drop.
To Chandler. 7 on the shot clock. From the left block, hits the bottom of the net. Inbound pass to Marbury. They bring it up court. 2:02 left in the half. Swings it to Houston. Pass to Houston. Beyond the arc.
You can't let that one go by without taking another look. When the opportunity presents itself, you have to take advantage.
Heinrich brings it up court, and with a bucket here, can get his 10th point of the game. The pass to Gordon. Passes to the baseline. The tough shot. Nice board by the 12-year veteran out of Tennessee. To Thomas. Passes it back to Marbury. Bounce off the back of the rim and in. Nice soft release by Marbury.
Stephon Marbury, Starberry, a guy I really enjoy getting a chance to watch play. He's always intrigued me with that explosive first step and his shooting prowess, but he's made great strides over the past few years into becoming a pure point guard that can distribute the ball just about as well as anyone in the game today.
Heinrich is called for charging, and that's his first foul of the game. Muhammad will leave the floor. Davis will come off the floor. The Knicks work it up court and they lead 18-16. The pass to Thomas. Bounce pass to Williams. 5 on the shot clock. The Bulls were the last ones to get a piece of it before it headed out of bounds. Off the inbound. It's ripped down for a defensive rebound by Harrington.
They can go 2-for-1 here if they want, but let's see how they manage the clock.
Pass to Pippen. Dishes to Harrington. Yes!
Nice bucket that time. Looking at it from another angle, it really lets you appreciate the athleticism of these NBA players.
The Knicks bring it up court. They're shooting 42% from the floor. 6-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pump fakes. Beyond the arc. 3 rebounds now by Curry.
Allen Houston thought he'd have a bit more room for that shot, but the defender read him so well, got close enough, and flustered him.
Passes to Harrington. Harrington. Misses the buzzer beater. Got it off in time, but the buzzer beater was missed by Williams. We've reached halftime with the score 18-18. Now that we've got a little break in the action, why don't we take a look at the first half with our ESPN game track. Phil, take it away.
Allen Houston has made some shots, and he's been shooting particularly well from three-point land. That's been a real help to their offense, and they'll look to him to make some big shots down the stretch.
Just won't be.
Kirk Heinrich has been getting it done too on the other side, and thanks to his efforts, it's all knotted up at the half. You get the feeling it's going to be a dogfight all the way to the end, with both sides scratching and clawing to come out on top.
Thanks, Bill. Both teams have taken the floor. It's time for the second half. Thomas inbounds it to start the second half. Now let's go down to Michelle Tafoya, who has an update for us. Michelle?
Thanks, Bob. During halftime, I had a moment to talk with the head coach of the Knicks. He said that even though it's a tie game, they need to take it up a couple of notches. They just haven't been finding the net with their three-pointers. He told them to, quote, make the extra pass and take the extra step to get closer to the basket. Back to you, Fitz.
Thank you, Michelle. He can't sink the free throw. He sinks the second. Pass to Houston. The leaner connects. To Chandler. Passes to Davis. Backs him down. Dishes it to the middle. Takes it in. Lays it right in.
That layup was right there for the taking. As long as you don't rush it, those buckets should be automatic.
The inbound to Marbury. The Knicks advance it. They're shooting 40% from downtown. Pass to Thomas. Swings it to Houston. Tries to back down. It's knocked away. Stolen by Davis. Dumps it to the middle. Puts the hammer down. They bring it up court. About 3.5 minutes left here in the third. From 18 feet away. Yanked down by Curry.
He was up there on the glass and came away with a defensive rebound. That's great hustle.
The pass to Chandler. Passes to Davis. 7 on the shot clock. Pass to Curry. Takes the turnaround Jay. Doesn't get enough under it. It's one-on-one. Spins. From the stripe. It's good.
That spin is a tough move to make and recover from, but it didn't hurt his ability to finish one bit that time, Fitz.
Heinrich heads up court, is shooting 50% from the floor. The pass to Dang. To Davis. Gives the up fake. Thomas ripped it down inside. Bounces it to Muhammad. Backs down. Skips it to the middle. Lets it go. Nice dish by Muhammad.
The Knicks are not giving up. Neither side is giving up. This is a battle for the ages, Fitz. The lead just keeps on going back and forth between the teams.
Pass to Davis. To Chandler. Passes to the baseline. Curry. That's the layup. They're running. Changes the shot. Curry gets the inside rebound. Passes to Dang. from 20 feet out. Ripped down from the stratosphere by Muhammad.
The defense did a very good job of staying right up on him, and his middling mid-range game just wasn't up to the task.
The handoff to Marbury. Skips it to Thomas. The pass to Marbury. Short shot and missed by Marbury. Unloads. Can't finish at the rim.
Nice position. That's it. That's it.
Pass to Chandler. Takes a step back to end the drought. Puts too much on it. The Knicks working up court and they're up by one. Swings it to Thomas. Skip pass to Marbury. From deep. Banks it off the front of the rim.
That's all any coach wants to do.
Nice.
Don't
give
him easy looks and always keep that hand in his face.
Feeds it inside. Dang. Drops in the pretty layup. Thomas inbound to Marbury. To Houston. He's double teamed.
Double up.
The Bulls get the tip. Fires up a shot from the opposite baseline. Not this time. We're at the end of the third quarter. We've still got a close one. The score, 25-24. Chandler inbounds it to start the final quarter. Pass to Dang. Passes to Heinrich with the crossover. Five on the shot clock. Pump fakes. Shoots with the clock winding down. Muhammad plucks the ball down from the rafters for that rebound.
Kirk Heinrich needs a little more space to hit that jumper reliably. Obviously, the defender had other plans.
The 12-footer off the mark by Houston. From 20 feet out, on the money.
He really came through on this play. You can see how he got into perfect position to score the second time around on the replay.
They bring it up court right around the 4-minute mark here in the fourth. The pass to Thomas. Pass to Muhammad. To Houston. From downtown. Heinrich rips it down off the defensive boards.
Credit the D for stopping that three. They didn't give him any room at all to operate, and he couldn't sink it.
Bounces it to Curry. Dumps it off. From the corner. Hauled down inside by Davis. Gets it to fall. The Knicks bring it up court, and they're trailing 29-24. Bounce pass to Thomas. Pass to Muhammad. Shoots from the post. Hauled down inside by Chandler. Heinrich advances it. He's got 10 points. Passes to Chandler. The pass to Heinrich. Tries to post him up. Puts it up. Beats the shot clock, but doesn't get the shot to fall.
Kirk Heinrich looked like the spin left him a little dizzy, Bob, and he couldn't knock down the shot, dizzy with possibilities.
Marbury, good.
Definitely a first-rate play. He was able to take control and get the best scoring opportunities he had available.
Inbound pass to Heinrich. They bring it up court, 2:33 left in the fourth. From 17 feet out, bounces off the left rim and out. The Knicks bring it up court, and they're behind by three. Dumps it down low. To Marbury. Pass to Houston. Puts up the tray. 17 points by the marksman out of Tennessee.
Back and forth, up and down, back and forth. They just keep trading the lead. What a game.
Passes to Davis. Looks to break his man down. Drives baseline. No good, and this is still a tie ball game. Pass to Thomas. From the left block, wrong good.
I like to play in real time, Fitz, but I like it even better in replay. I love seeing all the hard work that goes into getting a bucket.
The Bulls advance it. We have a two-point game. The pass to Davis. Dishes inside. Backs down. To end the run. It's ripped down by Dang. Gets the lay-in.
He drove that one right into the teeth of the defense, Fitz. I don't care how that one looked. That was not an easy layup.
The Knicks working up court, and they have a chance to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter. Pass to Thomas. The skip pass to Marbury. Seven on the shot clock. Shoots. Can't get the bucket from 20.
Stephon Marbury has a mediocre mid-range shot, but the defensive pressure was definitely above average.
The Bulls couldn't connect and were still tied up. The bounce pass to Houston. 6 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Chandler got the defensive rebound. Skips it to Chandler. Passes to the right block. Seven on the shot clock. Fires from the right block. Muhammad collects his ninth rebound of the game.
Fitz, they just can't get it to fall here in the fourth.
Gordon comes back in after sitting on the bench for a while. Tries to post him up. Off the inbound. Curry grabs the rock. For the win. Off the mark. Regulation is ended, and we're heading to overtime. The Bulls control the tip. Passes to the baseline. The tough shot. The defensive rebound reeled in by Thomas.
Ben Gordon has got to be upset that one. Anytime you get right to the rim like that, it's tough to miss.
Passes to Houston. The pass to Thomas. The leaner. Heinrich hauls in the rebound. That's only his third. Swings it to Chandler. To Davis. Davis. Board number 10 grabbed by Muhammad. From just inside the arc. Rebounded by Curry. Here's the break.
Stephon Marbury didn't waste any time jacking that one up. He might have rushed the shot a little bit, but I guess he was just trying to get it up before the D could react.
The layup was missed by Davis. Pass to Houston. Dumps it to Thomas. No good by Thomas. Passes to Chandler. The pass to Heinrich. Crosses it over. The pull-up J. Thomas yanks it down inside.
The defender had him hearing footsteps, and he couldn't maintain concentration on the shot. Nice D there.
Pass to Muhammad. Five on the shot clock. Gives the up fake. Shoots with the clock winding down. Money!
He was able to put his stamp on that one. When your number's called, that's the way you want to come through.
They bring it up court. 49 seconds left in overtime. To Gordon. Houston swipes it away. Spins from the high post. Money!
Now that's the way to finish at the rack. But so many players today will miss those wide open layups. It all boils down to concentration, just like he showed.
The Bulls bring it up court, and their backs are to the wall now. They must score here to stay alive. 6 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass it to the left block. Shoots from the post. Sweet rebound by the 10-year vet out of TCU. Inbound pass. Knocks it down. And bolt. Pump fakes. Launches beyond the arc. Bounced off back iron and in. He gets the first of two. There's the final buzzer, and that's the end of the game. The Knicks beat the Bulls 39-34. Both teams gave it their all for.
You can say that again. The Knicks will emerge from this ugly game with a victory. Neither team were setting the world on fire offensively, but they managed to get a few more stops down the stretch, and that was the difference.
Well, thanks. We also don't want to forget our player of the game. Houston had a great game. He finishes with 21 points, 4 rebounds, and he's our ESPN player of the game. That about does it. For Bill Walton, Michelle Tafoya, the whole ESPN crew, I'm Fitzgerald saying thanks for watching and take care.